Hey boys, it's Armnud. Today we're going to be customizing the Progen Emerus in Grand Theft Auto Online. This is one of the better handling cars in the game. If you guys have seen my stunt racing cars video, this is in it. We're customizing this today. Let's get into it. Alright, so because this is going to be a race car, I'm actually going to leave the armor off of it completely. For the brakes, we're going to go all the way up, of course, engine as well. The exhaust, we can do boxed exhausts, split boxed exhausts, twin boxed, sectioned, or radial. I like the radial exhaust personally, let's go for that one. For the grille, we can do a primary race splitter, carbon race splitter, primary sports, primary GT, or the carbon GT. I personally like the primary sports, I think. We're going to go for that one. For the lights, xenon, of course. For the livery, we can do several things to this car. We can go for a white stripe, black stripe, red stripe, white double stripe, race livery, redwood racing, jackal racing, narc racing, hexagon blue, camo livery, or none. I think I'm probably going to go for the jackal racing. I feel like that's a pretty cool look for this car. I'm going to go for that. For the mirrors, we can do secondary mirrors or carbon. We're going to go for carbon. The plate, yellow on black, of course. For the respray. Now, I'm not sure what color I actually want to go for with this. I feel like the orange looks good with a lot of things. I feel like it's a really nice shade of orange. So we're going to have to see what it fits with, honestly. I'm almost thinking like a yellow and an orange, but I don't know. That might be too bright. Honestly, the silver did look really good with the orange. These cast iron silvers and stuff like that, they're also looking really good. So maybe we'll go for like midnight silver kind of appeals to me. Let's go for midnight silver. Maybe secondary. What does the secondary even affect? I have no idea, but we're going to go for midnight silver. All right, for the trim color on the inside, it just does the stitching. So we'll go with something a little bit bright. We'll go for ultra blue. Why not? For the roof, we can do primary paint, secondary paint, carbon roof, primary vented, secondary vented, or carbon vented. We're going to go for the primary vented. I like the look of the full livery on this car. I think that's sick. Skirts, we can do primary skirts, secondary skirts, carbon skirts, primary race, secondary race, carbon race, primary sports, secondary sports, carbon sports, or we can do the primary GT skirt, secondary GT, or the carbon. We're gonna go for the primary GT just because it adds more logos and stuff, which I think is cool. For the spoiler, we can do a primary stock spoiler. Might end up going for that one. Secondary, black stock, carbon stock, sports spoiler. That looks really sick, actually. We can do that with the primary color as well as carbon and black, or we can do the GT spoiler or the street spoiler, which honestly probably looks the coolest. And I think we're probably gonna go for, oh man, or the primary aggressive spoiler. Man, I like the primary aggressive, or the secondary actually has a little piece taken off there, so we're gonna go for the primary aggressive spoiler. That looks super good in my opinion. Next up, we got the transmission. We're going to go all the way up on that, and the turbo. For the wheels, we're going to go for some high ends, and I think we're going to go for some Cheetah Carbon Rs just to match up with some of the other carbon fiber that's on this thing. For the wheel color, we're probably going to go for a orange of some sort just to match up with the rest of the car. Let's do that. Looks good. Tire design, we will actually throw one on. I'm not actually going to put bulletproof tires or window tint on this car because it is a race car at the end of the day. Let's take this thing down to the ground, do a little sound test and a review. All right, let's have a listen to this thing, see how it sounds. Sounds pretty good, could sound better. Not the best, not the worst. Off the line, this car has a decent amount of wheel spin, something that we don't really love, but that's okay. We will deal with it anyways. Now, this car at slower speeds does have some traction issues, but once you get it going, it becomes a very, very agile car. The Emerus is best at tracks that have long, sweeping, high-speed corners or fast corners. It's not very good at like technical stuff where you have to like slow way down and then take the corner. It's good for, you know, flying around a corner at very, very high speed and, you know, sticking the tires down to the track. That's pretty much what it's good at. With that being said, the car is extremely agile. It switches direction as soon as you tell it to, and it doesn't seem to want to spin out too bad. So honestly, I like that a lot. It's a very good looking car too. I can't get over how well this thing turned out. As you can see in these corners, once we start slowing down, the Emerus starts to kind of let that back end slide out a little bit, which is a bit unfortunate, but the car's got to have something wrong with it, right? So at the end of the day, it is a rear wheel drive car with insanely high horsepower, so it's not really surprising that the tail end will slip out at lower speeds. With that being said though, this thing does handle extremely, extremely well. I just wish, like I said, that it could handle the back end a little bit better, but what can you do, right? We got a spoiler on there. That's pretty much the limit of what we can do to increase the downforce back there. So we've done what we can. The car is just the way it is, and we have to deal with that. But it's not very hard to deal with, I'm finding. Except for, of course, right when I say that, the car does a full 360 and almost hits a pole. It's a good car though, guys. For sure, you will want this for, like I said, the faster tracks with some corners in them in stunt races. This is a racing build, so if you guys want to copy this, it is a pretty good build for racing. Anyway, guys, I think that's pretty much it for the video. If you enjoyed this, leave a like. If not, dislike. Subscribe if you guys are new. And I will see you guys in the next video. Until then, take care. Peace.